In 2003, MSF decided to set up a healthcare program here in Ankoro in response to the health crisis resulting from the war. Since the end of the conflict in the region, MSF has reorientated its medical programs and included treatment for women suffering from fistulas. Specialized surgical care was introduced, and our teams operated on 52 patients in 2 months. However, there were two women on whom we were not able to operate successfully.
After the war, my husband's brothers tried to persuade him to leave me and find another wife. But he told them he wanted to stay because he'd already put so much into our marriage. He ended up leaving me in 2004. I went away, and when I came home, I found out he'd married someone else. When he told me he was leaving, I asked him to help me get treatment. He said, "I'm ashamed of you in front of my friends. I've always wanted to have children. Even people younger than me have children, and I still don't have any. I want children first, and then I'll get you treatment."
Women with fistulas suffer continually. They're embarrassed about their incontinence. They can't be happy. The only solution to their suffering is treatment. Someone who is incontinent inevitably smells, and their husbands often leave them. Even though they've paid a dowry, they don't hesitate to abandon their wives, and that's a further cause of distress for these women.
Bonjour, Ilunga Nyota. Comment ça va aujourd'hui? Elle est sèche quand elle marche. Demain, on peut faire le test au bleu. Et la semaine prochaine, probablement, on peut enlever la sonde. C'est bon?
If the methylene blue test confirms that there's no leakage, Clementine will be able to go home just 2 weeks after her operation. She's been waiting for fistula repair surgery for 6 years, 6 years of incontinence. She was one of the lucky few not to lose her husband. More often than not, women with fistulas are rejected by their husbands. On top of the physical suffering, these women are subjected to the further torment of stigma and exclusion.
I realized I was incontinent after the birth. I gave birth at 4 o'clock in the morning. The child was stillborn. It was my 8th child. Usually after delivery, just after the child is born, you need to urinate. This time I didn't need to. But when I stood up, I realized urine was leaking from me. The next day, I still didn't need to urinate. But as soon as I stood up, urine leaked out of me again. I felt between my legs and realized I had a problem, that something was wrong.
Demain, on va vérifier toutes les sutures là. Bon, maman, merci.
Here in the maternity unit in Ankara Hospital, we regularly have to deal with complications during delivery. Frequently, we see very young women for whom giving birth can be a problem. They often need a cesarean. We also see older women who have delivered several times and whose uteruses are too weak for a natural birth. They too may need a cesarean. And then there are women who have naturally very narrow pelvises, and again, this can be a problem. Accidents that cause fistulas during home births in the villages are common. People don't know what to do during a complicated birth. For example, if it's not the head, but the baby's arm or shoulder that's positioned first, often they'll try to force the baby to change position, and this can cause a fistula. But even if the baby is in the right position, there can be other problems, such as a vesical globe, that can cause fistulas.
Okay, I'm going to take you through to the operating room, where we're going to do the methylene blue test. Your operation was 2 weeks ago now, so we're going to check whether the sutures are holding properly or not. Okay, gently.
The vesico-vaginal fistula, it's a communication between the bladder and the vagina. And often you have a combination between the vesico-vaginal fistula and the recto-vaginal fistula. Oh, he pulled it. You can do it. Just give it inside. Just give it inside. We see whether the blue liquid stays in the bladder or whether it comes to into the vagina. There is no leakage. It means the fistula is closed, and it means we can remove the catheter in 1 or 2 days' time. Bonjour, madame. Comment ça va? Venez ici. Installez-vous sur la table. In Europe, you haven't the fistulas. You don't see them because we have a very good medical infrastructure. The people reach in time the hospital. There is a good antenatal care. And in Africa, you haven't the people who teach you. This is something you learn in the hospitals. We are working when you are lucky enough and somebody is going to show it to you. The operation is expensive. A lot of suture material is needed. So, and the patients, mostly young women from rural areas, have not the money to pay for this. This is one point. And the other point is, in the 3-4 hours you operate a fistula, you have done 3-4 hernias or hysterectomy and other operations, which you can charge for, you know. And with this, you can make your living. So, okay. We have the fistulas, the more simple ones. It is just a defect in the floor of the bladder and no scarring and no associated lesions. These are relatively easy to operate and it does not take a long time. Then you have the more complex fistulas with the damage not only of the bladder and the bladder floor, but of the surrounding tissue. If the operation is successful, she can resume a normal sexual life. So it's quite possible that that she will deliver. But the next delivery has to take place in a hospital.
Virginie can be seen here selling food at the market in Ankoro, alongside other women. Until a few weeks ago, Virginie could not have imagined being a part of such a scene. She's 27 years old and has lived through 5 pregnancies, 3 stillborns and a miscarriage. She realized she was incontinent after her 4th pregnancy.
We went to the hospital 3 times. Each time we'd been promised a bed, but we never got one. We lost hope. So my husband and I decided to go and see a healer to try and cure this shameful illness. He gave me products with which I had to bathe myself 2 times a day, plant extracts that I had to use every morning and every evening. I followed this treatment, and it worked for 2 weeks. I had no leakage. I thought I was cured.
Here in the maternity unit, we recommend that women don't take herbal remedies during pregnancy, as they may harm the child as well as the mother herself. They can cause illnesses and complications that even doctors have difficulty treating.
Virginie was one of the first patients treated by Médecins Sans Frontières. Thanks to her operation, she has resumed a normal life.
When I was incontinent, I didn't dare go out. I didn't see anybody. But since Dr. Bernat operated on me, I go out, visit friends and family. I have a social life again. I go to church, I go to the market. I don't have a problem anymore.
Although there is little reliable data available on obstetric fistula, we know that over 2 million women are affected by this condition in developing countries. Every year, between 50 and 100,000 new cases occur. Without access to quality healthcare, these women have to live with a fistula and the resulting social stigma for years. Yet figures show that fistula repair surgery performed by an experienced surgeon guarantees complete recovery in 90% of cases.
Mazi wa ya soja mazi wa muzuri wa kujenga mwili ya watoto wa leo kila siku mchakula chao.